Another research design that is eligible for review under WWC Group Design Standards is a quasi-experimental design, or QED. Quasi-experimental design is one of those terms that means different things to different people. The WWC has a specific definition. A quasi-experimental design is a study design that has at least two distinct, non-overlapping groups and did not use a purely random process to form the groups. A simple QED identifies a group of units that received an intervention and compares that group to a group of units that did not receive the intervention. Researchers can choose these groups in many ways, which we will discuss next. Because the groups are not the result of random assignment, the QED approach does not provide any guarantee the groups are similar on observed characteristics. Studies that use a QED must demonstrate equivalence and cannot receive the WWC's highest rating. In fact, the highest rating a QED can receive is meets WWC group design standards with reservations. So QEDs, RCTs with high attrition, and RCTs with compromised random assignment all must demonstrate equivalence. As I mentioned previously, the WWC considers any study design that compares distinct, non-randomly formed groups a QED. There are many ways study authors might form groups. Authors may use convenience samples, which are composed of participants for whom a study author was able to collect data. For example, an author may focus the analysis on a group of classrooms in the same school. Although not all convenience samples make good comparison groups, right now, we're just focusing on whether this is an eligible design, and it is. Sometimes, studies use groups formed for another purpose. For example, two districts might plan to implement a new curriculum. A study might designate those districts as the intervention group and choose two other districts to form the comparison group. Other studies might use a national or district average as a comparison group, and that is an acceptable design for a QED as well, so long as they don't include the intervention group as part of that average. We also see studies that use specific statistical techniques to form a comparison group that matches the intervention group on baseline characteristics. Baseline refers to a point in time before the intervention occurred. The WWC also considers these acceptable QEDs. It doesn't matter whether the groups were formed before the intervention occurred or retroactively after the study collected outcomes. The highest rating a QED can receive is meets WWC group design standards with reservations. This rating means that the WWC has a lower degree of confidence that the intervention caused the observed effect relative to an RCT. However, to receive this rating, the study must demonstrate that the groups were equivalent on baseline characteristics. Again, we'll discuss baseline equivalence in the baseline equivalence module, which is module 3. QEDs that do not demonstrate equivalence receive the does not meet WWC group design standards rating.